Kernel Migrator for SharePoint adds Google Drive in it using two methods. First method is by doing the web authentication. First, user requires to enter user-defined project name. Then select the web authentication option. Sign into the Google account and click Next. After providing the account credentials, the user needs to provide some limited permissions to the software to access the Google Drive. Such permission will help the tool to see, edit, create, and delete Google Drive files. Also, the ability to view and manage Google Drive files and folders. Such permissions are helpful to complete the required migration. The software only requires the permission to enlist the data for selection and migration. Click Allow button. The Google Drive will be added to the software. The second method is for the G Suite account, where the user can provide the service account details. First, provide a project name and select the second option of service account. Then provide full service account email address and its P12 key. Then click OK. After providing the account credentials, the user needs to provide some limited permissions to the software to access the Google Drive. Such permission will help the tool to see, edit, create, and delete Google Drive files. Also, the ability to view and manage Google Drive files and folders. Such permissions are helpful to complete the required migration. The software only requires the permission to enlist the data for selection and migration. Click Allow button. All the service accounts associated with the G Suite Super Administrator will show to you. You can select the desired ones and click OK. The selected service accounts will be present in the Google Drive node. So, this is the step-by-step process to add the Google Drive with Kernel Migrator for SharePoint. For more information, visit the website. Thanks for watching, have a nice day.